Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly. From the Black Sheep Squadron, Denise DuBarry, Richard Dawson, and Mary Wicks, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, celebrities. Are you quite ready to carry on?
Yep. All right, let's carry on. First, let's say hello to our current champ, Mary Porter. Mary has $3,050 even. And as the time expired last time, she won another game, and she's going to play another audience match. Are you ready for it, Mary?
I'm ready.
Okay. Well, don't move
don't
yet.
Don't want me
now.
Yet?
Well, we'll do a little commercial business, and that'll give me time to pick you up and carry you like a bride across the threshold over to the blue spot on the rug. All right? I will do that after this, but not on camera, because I don't do those things on camera. You rascal. During the commercial break, we talked to the audience, and Richard and I were down there just doing a little kissing. I want you to know that I just came back from mainland China, and they have viruses there you wouldn't believe. You are all infected, because I not only kissed you, I breathed on you, too. Oh, but that was a wonderful experience. Hello, Mary Porter. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You got $3,050. Let's see if you can really roll up a big amount now. We polled a studio audience not too long ago. We said, you write down your best answer to this. Follow your blank. Remember, you get $500 for matching their most popular answer, $250 for matching the second most popular, and then $100 if you match the third most popular answer. And three of our six beautiful people over here, the BPs, will help you.
Richard.
Follow your heart.
Follow your heart is one.
Brett. Oh.
It's your and not the, isn't it?
Follow your blank.
Well, what I try to do always, and stay away from Charles, follow your instincts.
Follow your instincts.
Nipsey.
It is the, your, huh? Follow your star.
Follow your star. Well, third is tough now. Oh, well, what? All right, now we got to make a decision here with Mary Porter. She has to make the decision. The option of choosing one of those or throwing them all out and giving us one of your own, Mary. Follow your star, follow your heart, and follow your instinct.
I have to follow my heart. Richard.
Follow your heart with Richard. That's a lovely thought. Let's find out if follow your heart is up there. We'll begin as we usually do at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Follow your heart. You got it right off the bat. I thought it'd be up there higher. I'm really surprised at that. What's out of the $250 one? Follow your leader.
But it isn't that, it's follow the.
Follow the leader is what it is. Follow your nose. Shh, what do you think it's about? Follow your nose? Is that what you think? Okay, slide it, Ari. Yeah, you're right. Follow your nose. The audience said that. Well, anyway, Mary, you're going to play for $1,000 now. You'll take it?
Sure.
Oh, now we'll give it to you, but you got to come. You got to do the match first. This has to be a perfect match.
Yes.
And who are you going to try with?
Richard.
All right. Here we go. Good luck to you. Richard is ready. Pen is poised. This is it. Blank science. S-C-I-E-N-C-E. Blank science. Blank science. All right. You think about that for a second or two now, and then give us a response that Richard has given. If it's the same one, we give you $1,000. Blank science. Blank science.
I'm lost.
You're lost.
I'm lost.
Well, if you give us any kind of an answer, just any wild thing that comes to your head, you never can tell. It might be the right one.
Fiction.
Fiction science. Well, that's the reverse. It's science fiction. All right, Richard, may we see yours, please?
Political science.
Political science. All right. Christian science is another one. There are a number of good reasons. What was that?
Pure science.
Pure science is another one. Yeah. Now, listen, Mary, you can't win them all, but you're doing well so far. You've won three games, and here comes Melba Landon, your new challenger. Hello, Melba. Carousel, if you would, please, while we greet Melba Landon and welcome her.
Thank you.
And find out a little bit about her before we begin this game.
Well, I'm single, and I work for a chiropractor.
Yeah?
And I have something special to say if I can.
Something special to say?
Yeah.
All right.
Today's my mother's birthday.
Oh.
And I'd like to say happy birthday.
Happy birthday. What's your first name?
Martha.
Martha.
Uh-huh.
We can't sing the song because it'll cost $1.98. We do. Wish her a happy birthday indeed. Martha, wherever. Where is she?
She's here.
Oh, right in the studio.
Right here.
Happy birthday, Martha. Happy birthday.
Where are you, Martha? Oh, isn't she a darling-looking lady? That's Mom. Who's that with her?
Dad and my sister.
Your sister and your mother and your father. Those three people right there. Many happy returns of the day. Isn't she wonderful looking for 29 years old? Yeah. Anything else you want to say about yourself?
I'm very happy to be here.
We're delighted to have you. Let's get on with the game here now and see if we can give away more money. Melba, it's A or B for you.
I'll take B.
B? All right. Harry said, I think there's something wrong with my television. When I turned it on, Donnie and Marie were blank. Harry said that. I think there's something wrong with my television. When I turned it on, Donnie and Marie were blank. Thank you, sir.
I know how we can sing happy birthday. Sing happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, Martha dear.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. As long as you don't use a melody, I guess they can't make the tape for it.
Anything for that.
Right. Gotcha. Harry said, I think there's something wrong with my television. When I turned it on, Donnie and Marie were blank.
Elderly.
Elderly. Now, I think that's good. That's an excellent answer because, you know, they're young and bouncy and cute and all that young, and she said they're elderly. It's not going to get her any points, but what the heck? Nipsey?
The set could have been messed up, but sometimes when the set is messed up, you get an improvement in the picture, you know.
Oh.
When I turned it on, Donnie and Marie were black.
Black and beautiful. Ain't bad answer.
Oh, it's a cute little answer.
Right.
I think this is probably an answer that'll please many people, and they'd like it to come true. I said, naked as two Jaybirds.
Naked as two Jaybirds. Naked as two Jaybirds. Charles?
I was simpler.
Yes.
I said frowning.
Frowning. Yeah, because Donnie and Marie are always smiling, and they show all those teeth all the time. Melba says elderly. When I turned it on, Donnie and Marie were elderly.
I almost said nude, too, but I said horizontal.
Horizontal. Well, they're bouncing around a lot on the stage, and all of a sudden, bing, they did that. What do you say, Richard?
It was a tragic thing. They were not smiling.
Not smiling. And now, one more to go.
You said there was something really wrong with this television set, right?
Right.
Now, this is as far wrong as you could go, because these kids never would be drunk.
Drunk, right. I agree with that, indeed. So, Melba, that's the way it goes. No matches for you, and yours is coming up, but right now, this for you especially. Here we go. Mary Porter, are you ready for your first round question?
Ready.
Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How dumb is he?
He tried to put a blank on his handlebar mustache. That's how dumb Donald is. Real dumb. He tried to put a blank on his handlebar mustache. You finish.
Oh, I finished.
Oh, ooh, wonderful.
Oh, nothing.
Now listen.
Stick with me, you wear diamonds. Speak right up, Gene.
In July, you're doing, what is it? Damn Yankees?
No. July 17th, I'm doing Oklahoma and St. Louis. And the 24th, I'm doing Oklahoma and Kansas City. Then on August the 7th, I'm doing Oklahoma in... I mean, I'm doing Gamia. Oh,
You don't know what you're doing. She's in summer stock, so watch for her name. Everybody ready?
I'll be there.
Okay. In person. Dumb Donald is so dumb, he tried to put a blank on his handlebar mustache.
A bell?
A bell.
Bell.
Yeah, because a bicycle handlebar would have a bell. She said a bell on his handlebar.
He was so dumb that when his girlfriend told him go, she thought he meant leave. Put a bicycle bell.
Oh! I didn't think that was going to happen. Yeah, I didn't think that was going to happen. What'd you say?
I thought he tried to put the whole bicycle on there.
Bicycle on his handlebar.
Wherever you are.
Chuck, what do you got there?
He tried to sit a girl.
Tried to sit a girl on his handlebar. That's right. When you were a kid, you used to ride a girl on the handlebars of your bike. Did that very often. Right?
Right.
Did you ever ride that way?
All the time.
Yes.
Anyway, I said horn.
A horn. Isn't that close, but it's not a bell.
Really?
We had the same idea, just can't give you a match for that. We'd like to, wouldn't we, Richard?
Horn.
Yeah, another horn.
Well, Mary, you see where your friends are.
Right. What are you doing there, Mary Wicks?
Would you like a lesson in the language of the fan?
Yes.
He tried to put a bicycle on his handlebar.
Bicycle. But we wanted a bell there. So, Melba, at this moment, you're only one behind because it's 1-0 in her favor. We go to round 2 here. And we ask you again if you want A or B.
I think I'll try A, please, this time.
A it is. And A says, Fred said, the weather has really been terrible. In fact, we need this weather like Dolly Parton needs blank. You know Dolly Parton, Melba?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Right. All righty. Melba, Fred said the weather has really been terrible. In fact, we need this weather like Dolly Parton needs blank.
Boob implants.
Boob falsies. Implants.
Yes.
Falsies. Anything like that.
Yeah.
Yes. She's trying to cover all bases there, she said. Boob implants or falsies is what she said.
That was a silly answer.
It was silly?
Yes, like Dolly Parton needs silicone.
Silicone. Well, that's a match. That's one for her. And now we come to you.
Sure. I said bigger fanny flags or bosoms.
Bigger fanny flags or bosoms. Boob implants or falsies are not the real things. And that's why they did not match that.
Well, don't look at me when you say that.
Oh, okay.
You know this is the real thing.
I don't know what you're talking about. Yes, Charles?
I'm nearsighted and I haven't seen it yet. No. This is a definitive answer.
Yes.
A training bra.
A training bra. Not a match, though. All right, we need this weather like Dolly Parton needs...
boobs.
Boobs.
Those only count for horseshoes and hand grenades.
No.
Hey, quiet.
She said boob implants or falsies is what she said.
I said falsies.
You say falsies, so that gives you one. You're up to 2, Melba. Mary, what do you...
I feel this is in the same category. We need the weather like Dolly Parton needs padded bras.
Padded bras?
Right.
Well, that's a falsie. All right. So at this moment, the score is 3-1. And we'll see how this game ends after we see about this.
Today's consolation prize is our first. GE's rechargeable battery system. One plug-in recharger charges GE batteries up to 1,000 times. Now in gift packs in all popular sizes. And for Munsingwear, the Grand Slam shirt, comfortable mercerized cotton, and the famous penguin on the pocket. Munsingwear, the people who bring quality and fashion to life. And the Insinkerator's steaming H2O cap gives you 190 degree hot water for instant foods, like a built-in tea kettle at your sink from Insinkerator. And a windbreaker, and a supply of Armor All Protectant. Protects and rejuvenates anything rubber, vinyl, plastic, leather, and wood. Armor All makes your world less rotten. On with the show, and away we go with Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson, and indeed, we got to finish it all right now. Mary, here's the way it is. You need 2 to tie and 3 to win, and this is your assignment. We ask you, have you heard about the new song dedicated to physical fitness buffs? Well, it's called When the Saints Come Blanking In. It's a new song dedicated to physical fitness buffs. And it's called When the Saints Come Blanking In. Think about that, Mary. Nipsey, you do not play because you matched her.
Yeah, I matched both of them, so I'm not playing anymore this week.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Charles is finished.
Everybody's finished, Mary. Here it is. The new song dedicated to physical fitness buffs. It's called When the Saints Come Blanking In.
Jogging.
Jogging. Got the answer. Okay, Brett.
When the Saints come jogging in.
There it is. Score is now 3-2. Charles?
Get better with happy birthday. Jogging.
Jogging. We have a tie score. One more jogging physical fitness buff, and we will have a winner.
Jogging.
A winner. Well, now the landing. You know where to go, don't you, Mary? You don't need help from that, right? By now you do know. Good luck to you, my dear. We're going to send some gifts your way for Match Game 78.
Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us. Melba Landon. Bye.
I get to take your arm.
Yes, again, you get to take my arm, Mary. You got $3,250. You're getting up there, inching up little by little the hard way. Let's see if you can get a big amount this time. We polled a studio audience. We said, write down your best answer to this. Bouncing blank. Number $500 for matching their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for matching the third most popular, and three of our six friends will help.
Richard.
Follow the bouncing ball.
Follow the bouncing ball is a good one.
Brett.
What I love, the bouncing baby boy.
Bouncing baby boy, another well-known phrase.
Nipsey.
Now, wait, third is tough. Think about it for a second.
Now.
Just wait a minute.
Bouncing. Well, I was thinking Bouncing Beauty.
You were thinking Bouncing Beauty?
Yeah, I was afraid to think it, but I thought it anyhow.
You thought about it. So Bouncing Beauty, Bouncing Ball, and Bouncing Baby Boy are the three.
Oh, it's Richard.
Oh. Richard said Bouncing Ball. Follow the Bouncing Ball. Okay, that's what we want. Let's find out if it's up there. Hang on there now, Mary, and here we go. May we see the $100 number?
There's Nipsey's
answer. You get the idea, don't you, Steve?
Yeah. Would you have said that, audience? No. I don't think these are boob people here. May we see the next one, if you please? Bouncing baby boy. It looks good for you. Mary, keep your fingers crossed as we slide the big one. Boy, what a girl! Congratulations. You pick up another $500, but more important, right now you're going to play for the big one, the $5,000 one. Are you ready for it?
Guess so.
You want to have a go?
Yeah, I'll go.
With whom?
With Richard.
Okay. You stand a little bit this way. That's it. Face Mecca over here. I'll get it. It's worth $5,000. Good luck to Mary Porter. Here it is. Lower the blank. Lower the blank. All right, Mary Porter, she's got an answer. She's ready to spit it right out at us here. She had her answer as soon as I said lower the...
The boom.
The boom. Richard, she said boom. Everybody in the audience said boom. And if you don't say boom, we're going to lower it on you.
I was thinking of something that crosses a river.
Lower the bridge? No, they don't. Oh. Total of $8,750. Congratulations to you, my dear. Both of your friends out there. That's your son out there. He's so happy, I think he spent the money already.
Well, while you're wiping away your tears there, let's welcome your new challenger. Here comes Arnold Brody. Hello, Arnold. All right, there you go. Mary is very happy, Arnold, because she's got a bundle of money to her credit. And we welcome you, sir, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Right. I'm originally from New York. I now live in Hollywood, Florida.
Yeah.
Where I have my own chemical business.
Yeah.
I have three lovely children and a lovely wife. My children are Andrea, who's 12, Jill, 10, and Jonathan, who's 8.
Yeah. What brings you to California?
Business.
Well, we're delighted that you stopped in to pay us a visit
here, too.
We can't do any business with you. But does anybody want to buy chemicals of any kind? No. What do you sell? Sodium chloride? What do you
industrial.
Got?
Industrial.
What's that?
Industrial chemicals.
Industrial chemicals. I'm sorry. The market is very slow here on industrial chemicals. But Arnold,
on the side, I do part-time acting, too.
Oh, you a part-time actor, yeah. Right. Snappy dresser, too.
Oh.
All right. Watch this commercial and then see what happens after that. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time. Match Game 78. Tally ho!
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.